Hi, this is Billy at FormSite. Here I'll show you all about the PayPal Personal Payment Integration. The PayPal Personal Integration is a simple way to connect to your PayPal Personal account, but it's not the most current PayPal offering. The PayPal Business Integration offers the most current PayPal features like Venmo payments, Pay in 4, and PayPal Credit, and we recommend that everyone use that integration. Both methods allow your form visitors to pay with PayPal accounts or credit cards. In order to set up any payment method, I will need order form items on my form to calculate the order total. Note that I do not add credit card items to collect the credit card information with the form because PayPal collects that information during checkout. After my form is complete, I go to Form Settings, Payments, and click the Add link on the PayPal Personal Integration. I enter my PayPal account email address, then add an item title and item number to clearly identify where the charge is coming from. I can choose to create a custom success page and cancel page, and I can change the currency that my order form uses. Recurring billing is available and lets me set up repeated transactions for ongoing services or other multiple payments. I can change the interval and total number of payments, and the amount charged is the order total from the form. The Use Additional Parameters option allows me to add custom information to each transaction, and you can learn more about that by clicking the reference link. All that's left is to click Save and test my form. If this is the first time you're using your PayPal account to collect credit cards, you'll need to set it up to make paying with a PayPal account optional. To do that, log into your PayPal account. Click the settings icon next to log out, then click Seller Tools. Click the Website Preferences link and then scroll down to the PayPal Account Optional setting and set it to On. That will let users choose to either use their PayPal account to complete the payment or enter a credit or debit card. Here's how the payment screen looks before changing the setting. And after. Notice how the button appears to allow credit and debit cards. The best way to test a payment is to add a low-cost item to your form and make a real purchase, then you can refund the purchase in your PayPal account. Once I complete the payment, I can return to my results table to see that my transaction was completed successfully. I can click the History link to see the details of the transaction. The green checkmark in the payment column indicates a successful transaction, and the yellow incomplete icon means an unsuccessful one. If more than a few minutes have passed since the result was submitted, incomplete payments can be considered abandoned and means that the customer didn't complete the payment for some reason. There isn't a way to retry the payment, so results with incomplete payments can usually be deleted. If you have any questions about order forms, payment processing, or any other FormSite feature, you can contact us at FormSite.com and clicking the contact link.